We can't base our credibility on what we did 4 years ago or what we did 3 years ago. It has to all be current credibility. I want us to just all get bought in on holding other people, or not holding other people, to a higher standard than we hold ourselves, right? So when you get these teams, not holding your teammates to a higher standard than you hold yourself, not holding anybody else that's in this room to a higher standard than you hold yourself.
But I hear of sales managers, sales trainers, and things like that telling people how to do things and removing themselves and forgetting how it actually is done themselves. And that's why I'm still in the field today. Yeah. You know,
and leading by example is, to me, the only way you can truly lead. But with what you're doing, not only the aspect of it keeping your skills refined, but being able to teach and train off of current credibility. The opportunity for you to go out in the field with someone and you do the first call, they do the next call, you do the first call. But the ability for you to be able to do the call, how is a person gonna say, okay, I'll do what you say, if they can't see what you do? Like, it just doesn't work like that. And so I think the way that we've set things up here, where you're going out there and you're in the trenches with them, really, it creates a level of respect on the front end, but then it makes it to where, like, they know exactly why they're doing the things that they're doing.
You know, one thing, that's my boy. Steve Harvey's my boy, and I'll give him this credit. I listen to him in the morning at 6 o'clock whenever I can, but he said, without no test, you have no testimony. You can't tell someone else how to do something if you've never been through it. I mean, you might have an outline, but unless you've ever really done it, or you lived through it, or you survived it, you can't tell them. So what men really are supposed to do is to seek out someone else who has done it.
Knowing that you can just step back, let somebody else come in and take a look at it and say, this, 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 and this, and finding somebody who's been where you are. That's what, you know, I feel very confident in, is I work with a very specific individual who was where I was, or is doing things that I was doing that caused me to burn my whole world to the ground. So it's the pride factor of just being able to step back and saying, okay, dude, like, help me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm constantly looking for that 23, 24 year old guy who's trying to do something, but he just doesn't know the ins and outs of the universe.
But why you don't, like you just said, you looked at each of us and said the reasons you weren't gonna call us, right? And a lot of it's pride, right? Is our pride is not, you know, we gotta break our pride down a little bit. I mean, look at the fall of almost any man, right? Is their pride. If we can break that down, I mean, we all wanna be proud, right? But there's a difference in being proud and being proudful.